We have learned how to find the standard matrix of a linear transformation from a vector space V to a vector space W with respect to basis B for V and the basis C for W. We will now simplify this problem a bit. We will take V and W equal to Rn, and we will choose the basis C the same as the basis B. Taking V and W equal to Rn means that our original transformation is implemented by some matrix A. And even better, our coordinate mapping is now implemented by a matrix as well. So this means that we will be able to find our matrix M as a product of some matrices. How? That's what you will learn in this video. First, we will take a look at the coordinate mappings. So if we start at Rn with some x, then we have a coordinate mapping to the coordinate vector xb. By some phi b, and then we know that the xb, the coordinate vector, is the image of phi b of x. Let us take a closer look at that one first, because this coordinate mapping is now also implemented by a matrix. And how does that work? Well, your xb is a coordinate vector. Let's say it contains weights c1 to cn. Then we know by definition that your original vector x equals c1 times b1 plus c2 times b2 up till cn times bn over here. And now we can write this as a matrix times a vector, because we have scalar times vector plus scalar times vector plus scalar times vector. So we can turn this into a matrix. This contains its columns b1 up to bn times a vector which the weights c1 up to cn. And the vector containing c1 up to cn is of course xb. And we will call this matrix with columns b1 up till bn the matrix pb, which tells us how we can find x if you have xb. So x equals pb times xb. So actually, this pb is implementing the inverse of phi b, because we go from low to high with the matrix pb. Well, it's no problem, because the matrix will be invertible. So if you would like to find the other one, you just take the inverse of pb. Now we are going to combine this. So we have an x over here, and an xb over there, a t of x over here, and a t of x in the basis b over there. And we know that t of x in the basis b equals some matrix m times the coordinate vector x. Now we know that we can go up here and there with the matrix pb. And we can go to the right, over there, with the matrix A. But how are we going from left to right if we are down? Well, that works as follows. We know, well, first of all, t of x equals A times x, up. And x equals pb times xb. That's going from down, up. And t of x, similarly, on the right-hand side, equals pb times t of x in the basis b. And then we combine all of them. So we start off t of x in the basis b, so it's equation 3 over here, equals pb inverse times t of x. Then we are over there. We know t of x equals a times x. Then we are over there. And we know x equals pb times xb. Then we are over here. And then you can read off what your matrix M is. M is just pb inverse times a times pb. And how can you memorize such a formula? Well, just look at the picture. Say you start with your xb, so you start here. First you have to multiply with pb, you get over there. Then you multiply with a, you go over there. And then you multiply with pb inverse, so you go down. And then you're over here, and you are at t of x in b. So if you draw the picture, you can always memorize where the inverse have to be by just starting at xb and follow the arrows, and see how you come at t of x in b.